We're going slowly. Oh, oh man. I would like to shoot down a plane. This is my second battle. I've not been able to shoot down, or I haven't had the opportunity to shoot down a plane yet. Well, there you go. Dreams come true, ladies and gentlemen. So we have enough 50 cals armed to wreck this guy. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, Baron here. I'm really, really excited. Patch 1.55 is out. This is my first time playing El Alamein. Well, granted, the second battle of El Alamein. One of the new desert maps. It looks like over here, so in the top right corner, in about A10, is where the castle's located, and that is a pretty formidable castle at that. So I'm taking out the, T-17E2, almost an A-17E2. It's an armored car armed with two 50 caliber machine guns. It's technically SPAA, but at battle rating 1.0, the 50 cals are rather formidable. So it looks like this A-13, Shurja Vitanke. I'm assuming he's French-Moroccan. You know, just a guess, just a guess. He's heading up here. Oh gosh, this is a little dangerous, but rather a nice sniping spot. Oh my gosh. This map though, huh? It's beautiful. It's about damn time we get some desert maps. Honestly, I think the desert maps are the best right now. These would be perfect for realistic battles because even people with turned down, what would you say? With turned down trees and stuff, like that doesn't really affect deserts now, does it? Because the deserts don't have trees. Or bushes. I mean, there's some bushes, but you're not really expected to hide behind them. So I tell you what, man. I will be playing these maps all day in realistic. Alright, so we're going to just charge the enemy from the flank. It looks like everyone's just brawling out. They're actually near one of our spawn points. I think. Oh, we got to make sure we don't hit the rock. So what's cool about this armored car, look how dirty it gets. Is it's incredibly maneuverable at high speeds while it's going, but it's less maneuverable than a tank. The main advantage is the speed. And you know what? Those 50 cals just wreck. They're actually kind of, I think this thing is probably gonna get patched relatively soon because it's really, really good. It's almost just too good. Yeah, and look at this. The turning circles are a little wider, and like a tank has two treads which can move independently of each other. And obviously a car does not, so there's a lot of going forward and backing up. Wow, everyone's just kind of battling it out. Oh my gosh, this map is gorgeous, ladies and gents. Look at this little oasis we have here. I just want to do custom battles where it's like British versus Germans all day. I could do it all day. Low tier, historically accurate, like someone in the comments, let me know what tanks would be available for like the second battle of El Alamein, and those would be the only one, and like in what amounts. Gosh, recreations, gloriousness. So it looks like we might sneak up on a T-17 that's rolling in and wrecking my friends. Ooh, a Yak one. Oh, okay. We're going slowly. Oh, oh man. I would like to shoot down a plane. This is my second battle. I've not been able to shoot down, or I haven't had the opportunity to shoot down a plane yet. Well, there you go. Dreams come true, ladies and gentlemen. So we have enough 50 cals armed to wreck this guy. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. Oh, okay, so we've got destructible terrain in here. Now, I have an armored car, and if you run into some buildings, you can, crew members can die, or I guess get knocked out would be more appropriate. They could get concussions, you know. Alright, let's do this. Boom. He's only got one shot, man. Oh, he hit us in the engine. This is a problem. Covering fire! We'll just do it for thematic effect. And it looks like we could get in some ambush positions maybe on this ridge. I tell you what, man. Without a doubt, bar none, these are my favorite maps in War Thunder. At this moment, I think desert maps are perfect for those realistic battle players who like the detail on high. And I think it would mitigate the whole... Here we go. Is this the ambush spot? This is, isn't it? It's an ambush! Oh shit. This is a problem. Okay, he's dead. Are we repairing? We gotta repair. Alright, well that shows what happens when you run out of ammunition. But we're at 3 kills, 1 aerial kill. Looks like they're... Ooh, ooh. What? No! Oh, the sad face, dude. Artillery is indiscriminate, ladies and gentlemen. Artillery doesn't care. Just goes in, it will find you, and it will kill you. And at this tier, almost everything's able to get destroyed, damaged by artillery due to the low armament. Low armor, not armament. Alright, so there's someone in A. I've never been in this village before. I didn't get to check this map out on the dev server. I did a video coverage on it. Oh shit. Yo sir, pull your A-13 over. This is the British police there, poppet. Alright, he's dead. See? Some of these British officers have a shoot first, ask questions later approach. Look at this reverse. The turning circle, man. Oh gosh. Alright. Look at that. Oh, it's a Kugel wagon. Yes. Yes, please, please, please just put those in and let us be able to drive them in like persistent battles when that happens. Oh gosh, artillery fire. I'm gonna have to get out of here. I can't withstand artillery. Oh shit. Well, that was perfect timing, wasn't it? And I love how narrow this thing is. So it looks like our transmission has been hit. So we're not gonna be able to get into high gears. Okay, you know what? Let's just try it. Oh, well, there's that. And it looks like some people are going to be coming from the side of this mountain. Which way is yet to be determined. Let's flush them out. Not flush them out, that's more of like a block there, pass kind of a thing. We got some hits. That artillery's going to be good. We might get a kill out of that. Alright, if the tech truck's going in, we're going in. Goodness. See, I think the problem is these tanks don't have very many crew members, so it's pretty easy to destroy them with the 50 cals. But right now, I'm thinking it's going to be patched. It's going to be patched pretty soon. There will be a micro patch probably in the next day or two. That guy's on fire. Look at him. Ah! if these are your favorite maps and you think they're just absolutely stunning, go ahead and pull the trigger on the like button. Now, I'm not sure where this guy is. Okay, he just got knocked out. Our team's just wrecking. Okay, we're a tank ace, gentlemen. And ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, look at this guy. I am king. It's like, na zavenya, but are we away? But where's Simba at? Oh, he dropped Simba. Alright, so we're up in their spawn. It's pretty much over. Game's over, gentlemen. We've got someone spawning in back here. It's the only target. The poor man's fighting for his life. Na zabenya! Away. Hakuna Matata, ya titties. Oh, alright, yeah, that's absurd. That's a little absurd. Just a little bit absurd. Is it a little absurd? I think it's a little bit absurd. Say it's a little bit absurd, because it's a little bit absurd right here. Oh, we've got a spawn circle way over there. You know what? Let's do some joyriding, guys. Because this is gorgeous. The second battle of El Alamein. Baron von Anti-Aircraft walked out, got into his T-17E2, had a sip of good old Earl Grey, and he said, "You know what, you little kraut bastards? We's gonna take it right to you." He had his good old buddy Jerry. Jerry arming up them 50 cows, those Marduces that those rednecks over in the colonies did produce, and they're quite right. They're quite nice. Squire's rolling over right now. He's like, "God, that's just a terrible accent." And you know what, mate? You can bugger off. Because we's going to fight in the deserts. And we're going to fight in the castles. Sand castles, that is. And we're just going to have a grand old time. Ladies and gentlemen, the Second Battle of El Alamein and the T-17E2. Honestly, those 50 cals are just a little bit too good right now. We survived the entire battle. The other team got wrecked. Now, if this guy was also a T-16 or a T-17, that would be interesting to know. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, look at this. Let's check out the armor. This armor is actually fan-frickin-tastic. Look at this. If you're going for the crew with AP rounds, it's got 31 millimeters and it's rounded, so the effective thickness is pretty good. And this is sloped. A 40-degree slope, ladies and gents. Granted, if you fire an HE round and manage to hit it through it, you'll basically probably be able to take out the tank. That should be tested. Someone should do that and send me a GIF. Tweet me that if you'd like to. We've got these Marduces right here. In the front is a 45-degree slope, 22 millimeters of thickness. So from the front, this is actually a relatively decently armed battle rating 1.0 armored vehicle. So, you know, there's that. Look at that. Good old Squire over there. But 19 millimeters from the rear, it's not too good. It does use, it's a wheeled vehicle, which there are some SPAAs in the game right now. Like, I think the 4mm guys. It's a truck. So we do have trucks and stuff in the game. But, there's just nothing quite like this yet. It's the first armored car. And we've got two of them. We've got the A Armored Car Mark II. Let's look at this preview. Let's check it out. So, oh my god, I want to play this thing so badly. 31 millimeters of thickness, pretty strong. It's only orange. Does that mean there's a stronger part? And it's armed with two Orlikons. 20 mils. It's got a very high profile. But what is this? Battle rating 2.7. These 20s should do great. And tier 2 battle rating 2.7 SPA. This thing is going to be fantastic. It's also an armored car. So let me know in the comments below which armored cars you'd like to see in the game. Because I love discussions about stuff like that. I've got a Facebook post where we're talking about that. So if you want to check out Facebook and get into a more in-depth discussion as well, there's that option. Anyway, stay tuned for more action, ladies and gents. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm so excited. Patch 1.55. And we're going to take out the British Reserves. Reserves in Tier 1, obviously. So let's see. Looking at our rounds, I think we want those ones. Yep, maximum amount. Let's do this. So, we're armed with what? 250 caliber machine guns here. As you can see on this T-17E2. We're taking all the T. Look at all the Brits, ladies and gents. Gosh, you gotta love it. Oh, a Crusader. Already. Okay. But what I like about the SPA is you're able to shoot down planes and tanks. And I think these 50 cals are pretty potent at battle rating 1 and maybe even up to 2. So let's see, where do we want to go exactly? It's pretty maneuverable. Alright, we can't knock those down. But we can slide in between them. This thing is pretty agile, pretty nimble. A little slow on once it gets a little bit of momentum. Hostile team is capturing zone C. Let's see where we can go. We got Tetrarch sneaking around. All these Brits are armed with 40 millimeter main guns. Look at, whoa, what? Are you shitting me? I just wrecked a tank in some 50 cal shots. Something tells me that this thing's gonna get patched pretty quickly. Oh, since it's a car, it's not as good at traversing. That's actually really cool. Wow. Okay. Well, I tell you what, ladies and gents. We are absolutely wrecking. Oh, shit. Where'd that come from? Where did that come from? I have no idea. Was it through a wall? That would have been pretty damn impressive, honestly. No planes to shoot down, unfortunately. Oh, it could have been artillery, that's for sure. Not sure where that shot came from, but that hit us pretty badly. Luckily, it didn't kill any crew members. Just caught our engine on fire. And we're already at 2 kills with this thing. Tetrarch holding down this place. So armored cars definitely drive completely different, and that would... Whoa. Are we stuck? Oh shit, I just killed a guy. I killed one of my crew members. Look at that. He's dead. Was that the driver? Or the radio man? I'm not entirely sure. So this Tetrarch just bit the dust. Alright, from the front, we're not really good at dealing with A-13s. Man, there's going to be a lot of reversing and going forward with this bad boy right here. Alright. Oh shit. We gotta repair the tank, so this thing cannot withstand... Oh, here we go. Planes, finally. Yes, yes, yes. Come to me. No, no, not that way. Oh! We got a little distracted by shooting at planes. Yeah, but right now I'm led to believe that this T-17 is just an absolute beast and maybe a little overpowered at the moment. That would be my guess. I'd really, really love to find some planes to shoot at. Because that would really tie this up nicely. Destroy enemy vehicles in the air is also a challenge that's going on, so that would be kind of fun. Put me in the game, coach. Oh, there's something. Oh, it's an AI HE-112. The Heinkel 112. Dude, I love the Heinkel 112 A0 that only has 120 mil because it's got pretty good hefty rounds. And I think it's 150 rounds. So we've got to be very careful driving this because you can't run into any buildings or you'll knock out crew members. Oh, poor Tetrarch. He's going to have a bad time there. Can't also run into friendly tanks because that could also be bad. Bravo's getting taken over here. So if this Tetrarch goes, please, thank you. We're going to head around this way. Whoop. Go down this side street. There was a cruiser over there. That knocked us out. Artillery's going off. What do you see? Anything? What do you see, big guy? Keep your head in 50 cals on a swivel. We're driving this with reckless abandon. I'm not really not trying to die as much as I'm trying to just have fun, go adventure mode, and kill some stuff. No planes. Nothing to shoot at. Zone captured. Ooh, we got 5 silver lions for that. Yeah. This does not have as good of a turning circle as a tank because we've got 4 wheels. We don't have tracks that one can go forward and one can go reverse. We don't have that ability. But we are pretty thin and nimble. Look at that. So we're in the enemy backfield here. We're going for a touchdown. Ooh, Tetrarch. The Stuka and the A7HE both crashed. It looks like the A7 shot down the Stuka. That's special. Ooh, Tetrarch's dead. My intelligence, though, gave us the go. No planes? Nothing to shoot? These T-17s are incredibly fast. And got pretty decent gun depression. Oh, it's an enemy T-17. Oh shit, he's still invincible, isn't he? Alright. Eye for an eye. And a tooth for a tooth, love. And wow, those bombs were pretty well placed. So that is going to round it out. My first game in the T-17E2. And I've got to be... got to say, man. This thing's an absolute beast. 3 kills. We did die. We got ambushed by a cruiser. So that's all she wrote, ladies and gents.